Hi, my name is Maeve, Buddie, and I'm the lead singer and guitarist in Vulpynes.
My name is Kaz, and I play drums in Vulpynes. This is indiebuddie.com. But Maeve answered an ad I put up on boards.ie for musicians that were into the same kind of music and bands that I was into. So Maeve was the first to reply back, which was brilliant.
Yeah, it was like, originally I was only going to be the lead singer, because there was other members playing guitar and bass, and then we had a few practices together, and when that kind of dissolved, me and Kaz started playing just as a two-piece, and I started playing guitar, so I played guitar anyway. So, just kind of started off from there. We didn't plan on being a two-piece, so we set out to be one. But it was nice the way it worked out because we just clicked and we found that we just write music and beat together. So, yeah. So we'll find started. I don't think so. I listen to a lot of two-piece bands, but they're all very different. You know, a lot of people have asked to try and fill out the sound because there's no bass, but I never set out to do that. We just wanted to kind of play the songs that we've written and see how it sounded. And they just happened to be really, really loud. And full of distortion and overdrive, so yeah, there's no pressure. We just started writing music and here we are.
We don't really miss it because Maeve's guitar is quite bass heavy and with the drums as well. So and people who see us live and say they don't miss the bass at all. But now it just works.
Yeah. We always get the comments like, oh my god, it's so loud, or there's only two of you. Like I said, it wasn't intentional, it just worked out that way. And I guess that's our sound. Yeah, people are surprised. It was this guy that we used to see in a bar that we used to go to all the time. I'm trying not to be really vague here. And we used to be like, that's the guy, like, he's always there, he's always sitting in the same place. And every time we went, or before we went, we'd build it up, like, I wonder is that guy going to be there? And, I don't know, his name's Terry, I think I just made it up, which is kind of part of the song as well. And we made him out to be a total legend without really knowing him, so that's what the song is about. It's like building someone up on a pedestal and getting really obsessed by the idea of like this guy that you don't actually know at all. So, we've played in this place where we see him or not, so you know. There's a good chance his name isn't Terry, and there's a good chance he's wondering whether we wrote a song about him, so we like that mystery. These lyrics first, and then music, but that's not the formula, like it just kind of happens that way. And then we'll go to our rehearsal room, and I'll have usually like a lyric or a riff, and I'll start playing it, and Kaz will add drums, and it comes together really quickly as well, like, it'll be kind of like, oh, I have a hit that goes with this, and then it'll just evolve, and it'll be done really quickly. We write songs like really, really quickly. We kind of have our parts done really, really quickly. The song is done within a matter of half an hour, and then we'll work through it and we'll swap parts around. And there's no real formula to our writing process, it just happens. It's nice.
The lyrics are tongue-in-cheek,
and I get asked about them a lot, especially since we released it as a single, and I guess I never really thought that much about it when I wrote it. It's about having OCD, but it's about using it to your advantage, and you know, it's not suffering with it, it's seeing it as embracing it, like everyone has idiosyncrasies, and it's, not seeing it as a disadvantage, it's using your eccentric nature to your advantage.
We had plans at the end of last year, but it's kind of on the back burner at the minute because we just got really busy, to be honest, and we still love to do video.
We had plans to do it, but just like a lot of things kind of collided. And towards the end of last year, we had a lot of gigs and we were recording and writing as well. Definitely do want to do a video. I'm just not sure for what song yet, but one will come eventually.
Our live shows are loud,
full of energy. You know, like our songs, like, because we're kind of punky, so there's lots of like, they're short and punchy.
Raw noise.
Yeah. Don't really overdo it with effects. It's stripped back, even though it's really good. So yeah, we don't like to plan it or think about it too much. So let's just go out and play,
We did a couple of acoustic gigs as part of the Hardwood Class Heroes acoustic music group. Most of the songs I write on acoustic guitar anyway, so they're kind of easy to adapt. And there's still a certain heaviness to the songs. It's still us.
We don't change the actual songs. We just make
the music. It's literally just don't plug into anything. We just play the songs exactly as they are. And it's nice to have as a backup, if you're asked to play somewhere, take part in music trails or music nights. It's good to have that diversity as well.
I love playing OCD.
Yeah.
It changes all the time.
It does, yeah.
And our new song called Can't Sit Still is my favourite right now.
Yeah, that's the one we wrote most recently.
Yeah.
We usually change it. We have those conversations this is my favourite one to play. That one is my favourite one. But because I think this one's because it's new and it's really, really heavy. I was saying that to Kaz during the week, our songs are getting shorter and heavier.
And faster.
Faster, so it's a nice direction that we're going, we're happy. It's great. It was really different. Different venue, different city, different people. We didn't have anyone with us over there. We just went over ourselves. It kind of pushes our comfort zone. It was a little bit nerve-wracking, but once we kind of got into the swing of things, it was great. I think it was really good for us. It's a different world over there. It's so much bigger and you don't really notice it until you're in the midst of it. It was a really good experience. We'll help you be getting back over there soon. Hammer, not as loud. That's about it. They're really into the music. I think just Irish crowds, I think you might get a lot more wow. And whoops and random shouts, but
here's my five P's. So it is this advice kind of for every aspect of my life. Band or music. Proper preparation prevents poor performance. So it's really good. So in other words, practice a lot and prepare. And so often it's just human error and it's not because you're lazy or whatever. So
good.
It is good.
Five P's.
That's the next song.
Yeah. It's over. It's 5 P's. Done.
That is the next song.
That one takes care of
that. Yeah. There it's gone.
Best advice I've been given is not to soak up any activity. Not everyone's going to like music play. A lot of people like criticizing. It's everywhere, no matter what kind of music you play, no matter what kind of art you do. Just have to rise above it. And don't be intentional. Don't let it deter you. Let it spur you on. Let it get to you. Because if you're writing music, playing music, and you love what you do, and it feels good, then that's the only thing you should consider yourself.
Get involved, find other musicians if you can as well, and just jam, basically.
Make friends with other bands. We were really lucky when we started out. The night we played tonight, we knocked out of Fangclub, they gave us our first gig. They really, really helped us. Which is great to have that encouragement. Especially when you start out, it's good to have courage and encourage other bands around you. We're all in it together. It's no need to be competitive.
We have a gig in Chennai supporting New Valley Wolves. And we played Chennai a few weeks ago. It was really good, intimate, cozy little venue. It was really nice. That's on the 4th of March, I think. And then on the 7th of April,
We're going to play a few bands up there. We're just going to be on to Roscoe, that hasn't